Well, it's David Heine, Aspect Art. Today we're in the World Press Photo Exhibition in the Oude, Kerk. It's a new venue for them. And they have three shows here, a retrospective of the winner, the regular World Press Photo, and an overall retrospective of photographs from the world's leading press photographers from the early 50s. Some of them are frozen memories for all of us. Now, this is a show where we can kind of relive 99 through the eyes of some of the finest photographers in the world. With us today is the curator of the show, Michiel, and he's going to tell us a little about World Press Photo and about the show. So join us now at the Oude Kerk for World Press Photo. Photo in a new venue. How is the new venue going for you?
Well, so far we are very pleased with the visitors, and as you can see, this venue is as prestigious as the venue we had last year. And also, this venue allows us to present in a very proper way and in a very nice way three different exhibitions. And the nice thing about this year's show is that we have the annual exhibition, so as probably everybody knows already. But besides that, we have an exhibition of the overall award winner, Klaus Bjørn Larsen, focusing on subjects like Kosovo, Mozambique, the floods in Mozambique. And besides that, we have our retrospective exhibition on display, which actually covers more than 30, 40 years of photojournalistic history.
Now, digressing a little bit, maybe you could tell us, what exactly is the World Press Photo exhibition about?
Well, as I explained, we do have three exhibitions here. So the annual exhibition shows the results of an annual competition, and this year we organized it for the 43rd time. And we did receive entries from more than 100 different countries and almost 4,000 photographers. These people sent in their material to our offices here in Amsterdam. And we invite an international jury, representatives of the photographic community. They are, for instance, representatives of photo agencies, of picture editors of newspapers, and of course, photographers are included in this jury as well. They all gather here in Amsterdam and have a look at the different images that were entered. And every photographer is allowed to enter his material in specific categories. The jury, they go through all the material and judge the pictures in these different kinds of categories. We have nine categories, like nature and the environment, daily life, sports, arts, general news, spot news. We try to at least to cover the broadness of let's say, photojournalistic coverages in the media. Besides that, always the World Press Photo of the Year will be chosen during this judging, and this is the image that actually really stands out from the rest of it, and it's the icon of the year in which that specific competition was held. World Press Photo actually is a platform for photojournalism, which means that we're not only organizing an annual competition. And we're not only organizing exhibitions that are traveling to approximately 70 different locations worldwide, but we're also there as a platform, which actually means that we bring people together to exchange ideas, to exchange experiences. And I think that's the strength of World Press Photo. It's a very, in a way, centralized organization. We do have a database of approximately 30,000 people dealing with photography in one way or the other, and we as an organization are able to bring these people together either in workshops, either in a competition, either in an exhibition, and to let them fully benefit from let's say the experiences and the exchanges from all the other people, from the knowledge of let's say their colleagues and their peers.
Now this year you had a winner that focused a bit on a war that, as I was looking through the photographs that he had made, I thought how quickly we forget mm-hmm. the destruction of human lifestyles and how terrible it was in Kosovo. I mean, it's already off the news, and so it sinks out of our consciousness. But these photos really bring it back. Could you tell us a little about the winner this year?
Well, he actually the winner. It's the interesting thing is that as you and everybody expected, we had a lot of entries from let's say the war in Kosovo, and it was very difficult for the judges to go all through all this material because it was there was really plenty of them. And there were a lot of discussions on this specific subject, also referring to the different photographs that were on the table and were being used, being judged. But it's I think that this specific photograph of Claes-Bjørn Larsen really stood out from it's a very appealing photograph. If you look in the eyes of the man in the photograph, it's really he's really addressing you. There's a real need in his eyes. He's very desperate, and I really think that this specific photograph, in a way, represents what the feelings and the emotions are of the people that are fleeing or are refugees from something horrible in whatever country. So it's not only about Kosovo. It's more about let's say the cruelty humankind is doing to let's say to each other, and you can see from his eyes how desperate he is and how desperate he's looking for let's say a better situation.
Now a little about the retrospective that you have on one side of the exhibition. As I look through that, there are some of the defining photographs of our times, things that all of us hang our memories about a certain period. Could you tell us a little about how that was organized and mm-hmm. what it entails?
Well, the retrospective exhibition is actually an exhibition from the World Press Photo Archives. It's an exhibition that was being composed because of our 30th anniversary. And let's say an independent curator was invited to go through the archives of World Press Photo and to come up with a kind of retrospective exhibition. The only condition he had was that every single World Press Photo of the Year award must have been included in this exhibition. Besides that, he was totally free and independent to choose from the entries of each specific year to include images that he really felt like these are very strong images to be included in this kind of historical document. So that's how the exhibition actually came together. But it's also an exhibition that is still growing. It's an exhibition that every year is being, at least the World Press Photo of the Year is being edited to the selection. But besides that, this curator, whose name is Robert Pletch, he's the director of Contact Images in New York and Paris, he goes through the material that was entered for that specific year, for that competition, and chooses other photographs to be included in the retrospective exhibition as well. So it's a continuous and ongoing growing exhibition, actually.
In many ways, when I look around at the exhibition, the normal exhibition, as if that's what it should be called, mm-hmm. The annual exhibition, I see photos that are quite extraordinary, but don't seem to be something that you would see in a newspaper, for example. Mm-hmm. Is it a requirement that these photos have been published by a newspaper, or this particular photographer works for a specific newspaper?
Mm-hmm. No, well, the requirements we actually ask is that people should be professional photographers. But as you can imagine, people work very differently. Photographers work very differently as well. Some photographers are real spot news photographers working for instance, wire services like AP or Reuters. And the only thing they have to do is to make that specific photograph on the right moment and get it as quick as possible back to the office in Paris or New York, and then it will be distributed worldwide through the wires. And that's a very different way of working. For instance, if you compare it to someone who really works on a personal project for many, many years, and in the end he has, for instance, the goal to publish a book or an exhibition. So it's a very different approach. And I think that our exhibition or our competition actually allows both kind of approaches to be entered in this competition. So It actually means, for instance, in sometimes in a category like nature and the environment, we do get entries from photographers working, for instance, for National Geographic for an assignment for over many, many years. And also these photographs are being allowed to be entered for the World Press Photo Competition. So that's one of the, I would say, clarifications why you see so many different approaches in our exhibition.
Now, when I look at some of these photographs, they're so moving and so encompassing in just a single image. Mm-hmm. Now, we're here talking and we're on television and everything's moving and everything's live and we're talking away. Mm-hmm. None of these photographs get to talk, but all of them have so much to say. Why do you think we're still fixed by the image as much as we are? And the testament would be the people that come to your show here, mm-hmm. and there are lots of them.
Well, in a way, as you said before, it's you know, it's really a frozen moment in time, and these are the things you easily remember. And also, if I just observe the people watching our retrospective show, you see so many people with a kind of aha Erlebnis. When they are just watching or looking at certain photographs, they know exactly, for instance, where they were at the moment when the first man landed on the moon, or when President Kennedy was shot. You know, all these moments, everybody, I don't know, it's frozen in their head instead of, let's say, the rapid images that you will get from television, for instance. So I think that's the main difference. It really sticks to your mind, and it stays there forever.
We're in a new millennium here.
Yeah.
Does that in any way reflect in your show that you've presented this year?
Well, I think that this retrospective exhibition at least gives a very good overview of the recent history, let's say, of the past 50 or 40 years. And in that sense, I think for many people it's very interesting, because by the turn of this century, people do have that kind of tendency to reflect and to look back. And I think there are so many, let's say, human right kind of issues in this exhibition that many, many people will think of very carefully once they've seen the exhibition.
Now, we're, as I said early in the interview, in a new venue. Maybe you could tell the people where we are exactly, and when they can come and see the show, and how long it lasts.
Well, at the moment we are in the Oude, Kerk. The show is open every day from 11 till 6, except on Sundays it's open from 1 to 6.
Well, thank you very much for being with us today.